When bandsaws are produced, they are produced within very high tolerances. But you could have an old bandsaw that actually the wheels are out of balance. And I'm going to show you a couple of different ways of checking that. This is my bandsaw wheel off the bottom of the bandsaw. This is the driven wheel directly off the motor via the V-belt. This one will have been set up in the factory and tested for weight to make sure one part of the wheel isn't heavier than the other. And I'm sure they've done it on a CNC machine very, very accurately. The casting's good, but what they've actually done, they have taken three small drill holes out of here just to reduce the weight on that side. What I'm going to do is set this up and try and show you how you can test that possibly at home. But again, if your bandsaw is not playing up, don't play with it, don't interfere with it. What I've done, I've got a large ball bearing, which I've just set up on a hole in my bench. I've taken off the dust and any residue because that could add extra weight. And I basically cleaned inside the shaft and inside the other side of the bearing to make sure there's no score marks or any damage on there. If I carefully lift this up onto the bearing, I'm going to add some extra weight over here with some rare earth magnets. So this in theory should be the heaviest part of the wheel. And if I tap the bench, then this should drop down where the heaviest part is. Let me just set him up for level in two directions. So I'm putting him one way, that's pretty good. Bring him through at 90 degrees. Test them again. If you have one part of the wheel already lower, it will want to drop that way anyway. And you can see exactly what's happened. It's dropped where the extra weight is. So what you would need to do, potentially, I would do this 5 or 10 times. Just make sure it's coming down consistently. If it's dropping at that point, put a little chalk mark on there. If you take the artificial weight off, but if you were to do this obviously without any artificial weight on there and you're banging it and next time it drops over there, or next time it drops over there, then basically there's not a problem with the wheel, it's well balanced. But if consistently you're getting readings around this area, we know that's too heavy. So either you could take small drill holes out as they have done, but be very, very cautious and make sure your wheel really is wrong before you start drilling holes out of it. Or the other thing you could do is perhaps on the opposite side, which you think is then the lighter side, you could perhaps add rare earth magnets if it's on a cast iron one, until we get to a point where we're getting an inconsistent drop. It's like balancing your wheels on your car. You take your engineers or mechanics, and they will put little clips on there, same sort of thing again. But be very cautious and test it in a few different positions. If I test this on another bench in my workshop or a different hole in the bench, I might get a different reading because the bench might be doing something. So test it in a few different places around your workshop before you commit yourself to drilling, because you don't want to cause yourself more problems. You might be chasing your tail all day long. Only tackle this if you really think there's a problem and you've isolated there's definitely a heavy spot within the wheel.